Okay, so I did I ask you to make a two row by three column matrix and try to show that for number two that it was 1-to-1, that if you could get it to be 1-to-1. So I asked you just to multiply things out. And a theorem in your book tells you that if the null space of the matrix is just 0, then the matrix is a 1-to-1 linear transformation. And so setting that equal to 0, you can easily come up with values, like Stephanie came up with values A equals 1 and E equals 1 and the rest of them are 0, and come up with a solution that gives you 1-to-1. But you can also easily make up solutions where you have a lot of free variables and you don't end up with a null space equaling just 0. So it's easy, starting with this framework and setting it equal to 0, to create an example that gives you 1-to-1 and create an example that doesn't give you 1-to-1, just by making the right choices in the A, B, and C, and the D, and so forth.
How do you end up with three columns? All the matrices here have a 2x2.
No, this is number two. I asked you to work with non-square matrices. So here's another non-square matrix. I just wanted to give you an example showing you that it's possible to take a non-square matrix and get it to be 1-to-1. So if I solve for the null space, and you had many examples that look like this, and for some reason I did this by hand, I already know, I don't have to do the rest of the work, because I already know it's all she wrote. You know, I've got a 1 here, and then I'm going to knock out this 2 here with that 1, and I'm done. So I'm going to get from this that x1 is 0, and x2 is 0, so the only thing in the null space in this case is going to be the vector 0, 0. So it's definitely possible to get non-square matrices being 1-to-1. So I wanted to show you this aside. I asked you a question in class. Is it possible to get linear transformations like we had with the cubic function in Calc 1, where you'd have a cubic function that's not 1-to-1, but it is onto, and then we made the arctan, which is 1-to-1 but not onto. So you can go one way or the other with these functions that you draw in Calc 1. Is it possible to do this with linear transformations? And the answer is, with square ones, no. Here's the problem. If you have a linear transformation that goes from Rn to Rn, then the matrix that's representing that linear transformation is going to be square. It's going to be n by n. So assume that this transformation is 1-to-1. Well, then there's a theorem from your book that says that the null space is only the 0 vector. There's nothing else in it. Well, that means the nullity is 0. But the rank nullity theorem says that rank plus nullity equals 0, or has to be n, right, the dimension of the space. Well, that forces the rank to be n. The rank is the dimension of the range. But then the dimension of the range are all the y values, but the dimension of the range has to be Rn, because if the dimension of the range is n, then the range itself has to be spanned by I, j, k, all the basis vectors, right? So you get all of Rn. Everything's covered. And if every y value is covered, like when we drew the pictures of x cubed, for example, you see all the y values were covered from minus infinity to infinity. In this case, if we're in Rn, we can't draw it, but all the y values are covered, that's onto. So it's a slippery way to get out of onto. Actually doing let the y equal. I'm going to show you another one later, a proof with where you have to actually get in there and use the definition of onto. So number three, I ask you to look at this matrix and show that it's onto, an onto transformation. And I asked you actually to calculate this. So this is my arbitrary y here. And I want to know that there's an x that led to this y. So my object here is to solve for the x1 and x2 that yield that y, that arbitrary y. So can I get a formula that yields that y? Just like if you have y equals x cubed, you'll have a formula that yields you any arbitrary y. You just take the cube root of y and stick it in for x, and it'll work. Well, yeah, I can do this. It's x1 equals y1 minus y2, and x2 equals y2. It's a simple math that you used to enjoy back in high school. So then, given an arbitrary y, we've got an x such that ax equals y. That's the definition of onto, that with any arbitrary y, I've got a formula for the x to give me that y. Every single y is covered. So let's do this with numbers. Let's just pull a y out of the hat. Let's pull that one. Y equals 1, 2. Is there an x that gives me that y as an answer? My formula says the x has to be y1 minus y2 and y2 in the second component. So let's see if that works. Let's put it in there. And it does. This time I didn't make a mistake. So this x yielded that y. So that formula is telling me no matter what y I pull out of the hat, I've got a formula that will give me an x that will send it to that y. So it's onto by definition. Okay, so I'm going to let you think about non-square matrices, and then we'll cover this again.